What's up YouTube? What's up everyone? I'm back with a new video. So happy new year, by the way, to everyone. I know it's kind of late to put a video. January was kind of packed for me, so it was really hard to put videos, but now I have more time, so I'll do my best to put a lot of content. And that's the thing, this year I was also thinking, like, what can I do this year? So I have so many bright ideas and I can't wait to share with you guys. So but now it's time for top 10 movies of 2022. I was like working so hard on this video, like it took me a while, I will admit. But guys, witness a nice intro that I made for you guys. And let's keep rolling. Also, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe, please. And don't forget to give a huge thumbs up, a like, because that really helps my channel. So guys, with that out of the way, let's enjoy the intro, shall we?
Over the next few hours, you will ingest fat, salt, sugar, protein, bacteria, fungi, various plants and animals, and at times entire ecosystems. But I have to beg of you one thing, it's just one. Do not eat.
The menu is a huge surprise to me. It's a movie filled with social commentary and some dark humor. The story follows a couple who go to an isolated island to try the finest cooking of Chef Slowik. The menu of Chef Slowik will have some surprises and some radical and unexpected twists. This movie really shows how the demand can drain someone's passion and make them lose their way. The cast of this movie is phenomenal, with Ralph Fiennes, who previously portrayed Lord Voldemort on Harry Potter. You have also John Leguizamo, Nicholas Hoult, The Fantastic, Anya Taylor-Joy, and many more. Also, I would love to point out that the cinematography of this movie is beautiful, and every shot of the food is brilliantly executed. This movie left me hungry for more, and if you watch this movie, don't forget to get yourself some food because you will need it. I would have loved to have a cheeseburger.
My mother told stories about a place like this, a protected land with people that never have to leave, that never have to change who they were. What reason do you have to reveal your secret to the world?
I am not a woman who enjoys repeating herself. Who are you?
I have many names. My people call me Ahkukunkan, but my enemies call me Namor.
The 30th movie of the MCU, and probably the most difficult movie to watch for an MCU fan, and to film for Marvel, because of the loss of the great Chadwick Boseman. This movie had too much going through, because its main lead unfortunately passed away, and they decided to not recast T'Challa, but to focus instead on Wakanda and its people. Many fans were left wondering how this would work, and others had a lot of concerns. For me, Ryan Coogler did it. He did something that seemed impossible. He delivered a beautiful script that focuses on Wakanda and its citizens, and it takes its time to show how each main character deals and go through with the loss of their king. The movie lacks sometimes of action scenes, but when they decide to throw an action scene, it's worth the wait. Also, Ryan Coogler and Marvel introduced a fantastic antagonist and added a new community to the spotlight. Namor is so well written, Coogler and his crew really took time to explore and understand Mesoamerican history, and I think they delivered a wonderful message and made a continent proud to be represented on the big screen. Robert Pattinson proved to the whole world that he is vengeance. Everything in this movie feels more realistic, from the supporting characters, the superheroes, the criminals, and Gotham. This new version from Matt Reeves is more grounded and puts on the spot a young Batman who is still struggling with his tormented thoughts. The movie dives more in the psychological aspect of Bruce Wayne. You can see an angry Bruce who reflects that anger in every punch he gives to criminals. This movie feels different from the other Batman movies. The soundtrack is outstanding and the action is well handled. Paul Dano as the villain Riddler is well cast and he gives me chills every time he was on screen. It is fair to say that the movie takes its time and it could drag from time to time. Some will find it long, and I felt that way too in my first watch. But in my second watch, I understood what Matt Reeves was trying to do with this movie, and I appreciated this movie even more.
Olivia Allen is gonna go out with me?
That's right.
The famous actress?
Yes.
The beautiful one?
Yes. You'll go out on a few dates.
With me?
Correct. And she'll pretend to be in love with you.
In love, like, you know, like, hugging?
Hugging? Probably some kissing?
Kissing? And how much do I have to pay?
No, we pay you.
This movie is a remake of a French film of the same name. In this movie, Antonio Flores is a Los Angeles parking valet who will find its life getting some attention after he was caught on a photo with a famous actress and with her lover who she was having an affair. To cover up the story, the famous actress Olivia and her lover Vincent will agree with Antonio to pretend that he and Olivia are a couple. People will have a really hard time to believe that a famous actress would be in couple with a random Latino valet. I didn't expect much from this movie, and I must say, it really surprised me and made me feel so many emotions. Eugenio Derbez and Samara Weaving are very sympathetic and very relatable characters. Their chemistry is really charming, and the story deals with some interesting situations that both are dealing on their own. This movie might not be the best movie. I don't even think a lot of people have put this movie in their top 10 or even heard of it, but that's the charm of this movie. It's not pretending to be the best movie of the year. It just wants to be a fun, charming, small, uplifting rom-com, and that's all that I need. Also, I might be a bit biased because I love Eugenio Derbez and of course the legendary Carmen Salinas. Their scene in this movie is so hilarious. It was a bittersweet experience for me because this was the last movie of Carmen Salinas because she unfortunately passed away. Thank you for putting a smile on my face, Salinas.
Hey,
Quiet on the Western Fronts is a German movie on Netflix about the First World War, showing the German side of the story. The movie is realistic and well executed. There are so much brutal, cruel, and bloody moments throughout the movie. Those moments will tighten up your heart. The music is fantastic. Every battle that takes place, you feel like you're in the moment. You feel every bullet, every flame that's burning a German soldier. You can feel it on your skin. That's all thanks to some fantastic camera maneuver and a good cast. This movie is so realistic that after watching it, you will feel dirty. You will feel sad and just confused. This movie might not be for everyone, but it's a piece of art as a movie that I really, really recommend to cinephiles. Like they say, never bet against James Cameron. 30 years later, James Cameron releases the sequel to Avatar and brings us back to the world of Pandora. Going to the movie theater, I will admit that I completely forgot about the first Avatar movie. And that's not a problem, because the movie takes its time to explain some of the important aspects of the first movie. This time, Cameron takes it further with the expansion of his world Pandora and really focuses his time on the characters and the story. The concept of family is so centered and important in this movie. The script is so well written that every big moment feels earned, natural, and satisfying. The action scenes in this movie are insane as well. Avatar: The Way of Water is a beautiful piece of art with its visuals. They are so stunning and worth watching it on IMAX. Cameron proved to everyone that he still got it. And it seems that he's not stopping soon.
Done. Bola.
Main Kolaba ke Little Dots Play School se baat kar rahi hu. Naina Jaiswal, yahan ki teacher. Maine 16 bachchon ko hostage bana liya. Aur meri kuch demands hain.
A Thursday is an Indian thriller movie released exclusively on Disney Plus Hotstars in India. The story centers around our protagonist Naina, who is a teacher in a kindergarten. Everything goes as it should normally go in a kindergarten until Naina suddenly calls the police and says that she holds every kid in her class hostage and that she is armed. She wants the police to obey her request, or else something terrible might happen to the kids. The plot of this movie is really intriguing, and the suspense keeps you on your toes, and you want to know what's going to happen. This movie really surprised me for the main protagonist's acting, for the many unexpected twists, and for its strong message that I didn't see it coming at first. Some could think that there are too many ingredients to cook in one movie, but I believe director Behzad Khambhata mixed everything so well. Obviously, big shout out to Yami Gautam because she really steals the show as well as the other cast. Her presence is so menacing, and that's also thanks to a great cinematography from the director and his crew. Honestly, that's everything I need in a thriller movie to enjoy it, and it left me with a unique experience coming from someone who is less familiar with Indian movies, but thrilled to continue exploring it. Before we go through with my top three movies, here are some honorable mentions that almost made the list.
Oh my God, you're the girl from the Paris attacks.
Let's not forget the signature red beret.
Hi, I'm Danny.
Rowan, welcome to group.
We're all survivors here. Do you want to share?
If you're not okay, that's okay.
You die, you are down to your last life. Mama Luna is always on the lookout for a new lab cat.
I am no lab cat. I am Puss in Boots.
Not anymore.
To me, the world is rich with funny words. They ring like bells, those tiny words. They go, they shine, they dance in my mind like a chorus.
A beautiful stop-motion animation that is set in the fascist Italy. This animated movie has a lot of heart, includes a lot of dark themes, and is sometimes really sad to watch. I will admit at first, Pinocchio is really annoying when he's first introduced, but that's the focus point that the movie explores with the help of other characters such as Geppetto, Count Volpe, Sebastian, and of course Candlewick. Some of the songs are so memorable, like Ciao Papa and My Son. When you look at the special documentary of behind the scenes, you can see that Guillermo del Toro really put his soul and his heart in this animated movie. Not everyone might enjoy it as I did, but I'm pretty sure you will find an element to appreciate. This is by far the best adaptation of Pinocchio that I've seen so far. Guillermo del Toro really did an amazing job. That man is so unbelievable. Is there a thing he can't do? Because at this point, nothing seems to be a barrier for Guillermo del Toro. Thank you so much for this movie. I had so many emotions, and it was one of the best movies to watch on 2022.
Lend me your voice. Let me see your face. Let me start to show you what I see. Bring me close.
Belle is a movie directed by the great Mamoru Hosada, who previously directed great hits like Mirai, The Boy and the Beast, Summer Wars, and The Girl Who Leapt Through Time. The movie is a modern reimagining of the French fairy tale Beauty and the Beast. The story follows our protagonist, Suzu, who uses an application called You, in which she becomes a celebrity for her stunning singing and her avatar called Belle. She often uses this application to feel safe from the outside world and from herself. Before I go any further, I just want to clarify that this movie came out in 2021 in Japan, but it came out on theater worldwide in January of 2022, and that's why I'm putting it on my list. Sorry for the confusion, that's the problem of dubbing sometimes. This movie puts in front the high and the lows of online stardom and how we search for safety and comfort online rather than face the reality that lies ahead. Hosada presents a movie filled with real issues in society, a visual and vocal masterpiece, and a strong voice cast. This movie was a fantastic experience and just left me wanting more. I can't get enough of the beautiful soundtrack and the strong message of the movie. The only thing keeping me from putting this movie at the number one spot is because I did feel the movie was a bit long at some parts, but regardless of that, it's still a phenomenal movie that I strongly recommend to everyone.
Thank you.
coming in the number one spot is just a fabulous movie. In this movie, you have action, you have tension, you have emotion. This movie is really entertaining, even if you don't like aircraft. Tom Cruise, director Joseph Kosinski, and story writers Peter Craig and Justin Marks made a sequel with respect to its source material, with a movie with heart and with the right amount of nostalgia. The writers really pay respect to the first Top Gun characters and integrate well the new cast members in an organic way. Tom Cruise really brings his A-game here, with a stunning performances from him and from the rest of the cast, such as Miles Teller and Jennifer Connelly. But let's be real, if this movie made a $1 billion last year, it's because of its breathtaking action scenes, filmed in real aircrafts, with the right amount of special effects and green screen. You feel like you are the pilot and that you are fighting for your life. This movie has some amazing sequences of aircraft that I didn't know was possible and I didn't know I needed. For me, this was the best theater experience I had this year. I think it's mainly because I didn't know Top Gun and I didn't expect much, and it just blew my mind to the sky. And that's why it deserves for me the number one spot.